Welcome back from That Should Break You. Still watching Abin to the Radio and Abin Television. It is Kachai this morning, and we're going to be talking about, you know, improving school to work transition as far as univocational skills are concerned, or any particular skill that is hands-on. And of course, how do you use the skill to better yourself the moment you leave, you know, school, and it's about that time to start working and get your hustle to be real. Now, this morning, we shall be talking to a fashion designer who has not only used her dream to inspire other people, but she has also used her dream to make some money, you know, understanding the fact that she moved from school, now she's into the working business. Want to find out how has this been happening, and you who's watching us at home, what do you get to learn from this particular one? She goes by the names of Janet Mpambara. Good morning to you.
Good morning.
How are you, Janet?
Fine, thank you. How are you?
Very fantastic. It's good to have you on the show. I want us to talk about, you know, your dream, fashion designing, and how you have used it to transit yourself from school into the working environment. First and foremost, would you tell me about yourself? When we talk about Janet Mpambara, what should come into our minds?
Okay, I'm a fashion designer. Mm. Starting out, I'm not yet that big, but I'm starting out. Mm. I'm 24 years old.
Oh, okay.
I went to Uganda Christian University, studied accounting and finance. Mm. Mm. But along the way, I realized, oh, I think I don't like...
You're wasting time in accounts.
Yeah. Yeah. So after school, I had a job for like around 3 months. Mm. Then I left and went to volunteer somewhere in Juba. But then also while I was there, I was just trying to figure out how am I going to start, what am I going to do. Mm-hmm. And then towards the end of 2018, that's when I started the fashion line. Mm. And yeah, here I am.
Wow.
Well, so, and that's a good, she makes it sound like it is very simple.
I want to know what...
But it wasn't.
What made her realize that whatever she was doing with accounts was wrong?
You didn't feel it?
It comes from a point where you realize, am I happy? Waking up, going to do this every single day, does it make me happy? Does it, do I have peace with it? Mm. Mm-hmm. And then you realize, okay, I'm not finding my happiness here.
Which let me means try your productivity out, would be low.
Yes, let me try out my passion, let me try out something I actually love, something that I would do happily, earning from it, but still enjoy life.
When did you realize that you wanted to do fashion?
From a long time ago, really.
So it's always been a part of you.
Yeah. It's
so why didn't you do fashion designing probably at campus? Why did you have to do accounting?
You know this dogma where
you're supposed to have, your parents expect you to have like a lined up.
Yes.
You know, and like a lawyer, either a lawyer, a doctor.
Exactly.
Oh, so they wanted you to be an accountant as if.
Yeah. And also, you know, when you grow up with this kind of African setting of, you know, you want to make your parents proud.
Mm, true.
Mm. And you also want that when you're in a community, they didn't say, she just went to school and did this. So you want something substantial, something that holds water, but not realizing that it's your life. It's not anyone's life.
It's your life.
Yes, it's your life.
Okay, now let's talk about transitioning from school into the working environment, because I know we had that same conversation, I think, last week.
Yes.
And the conversation was when these kids got out and they asked, what next? That is a transition from school into the workforce. What would be those few things you would tell another person who just left campus or is at campus and planning on leaving but doesn't know what their next is?
Okay, for someone who is at campus and doesn't know what their next is, it worries me. Yes, because you're there, you're studying, and when you went to school, you knew what you wanted.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I'm thinking, why does it happen all the time? Why don't people plan? I'm getting out of school in a couple of months. Mm-hmm. What am I going to do? Why do you have to wait for your graduation to ask what next?
Some of them wait for their transcript.
What I did, when I went out of school, I was lucky. I got a job before grad. That is a job I had before grad. And, you know, if you can do something like that, volunteer somewhere, work to an office, tell them I'm graduating soon and I would like to camp here for a while, you know. And that could be also a way of getting a job when you graduate. Because if they see you, how hardworking you are, how determined you are, of course they'll give you a job when you are done.
True.
Okay.
Yeah, so have a plan before you finish and know, like, what next? What next? Don't wait for grad.
Talking about having a plan, you know, you are a very good example of what is happening to very many students at the university right about now. People are studying things that they are not really interested in as far as passion is concerned. What is your best advice for someone who is, you know, studying something and yet their mind and passion is somewhere else, as far as, you know, maybe the vocational skills is concerned?
I would tell that person to live your life. Don't leave it for your mom, don't leave it for your dad, don't leave it for our society, but most importantly, love what you do.
Mm-hmm.
Because if you don't love what you do, you're not going to be productive.
Okay.
Yeah, so you have to love what you do, you have to love what you're studying
mm-hmm.
for you to actually make it in life.
Okay. This fashion design of yours, is it a full-time job or, you know, it's a part-time?
Full-time.
So you wake up in the morning and you have like a showroom, so you wake up and go to the showroom?
No, like when I was starting, I said I'm not that big yet.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
So I have a room at home, what I call my office,
mm-hmm.
and that's where I work from.
And
so basically, your entire 3 years at the university have gone to the dustbin?
No.
I mean,
Handy Wentz is calculating
how
much money
she
made from her sewing.
Yes.
Really?
Yes. Yeah.
Does it
I
mean?
Did accounting and finance, it comes in handy. You know.
Very handy. She's
yes.
a business starter, so.
Yeah.
I mean, she has to count her pennies before you get it. Will come in handy. I don't think it was wasted at the end of the day. But so when you decided to do fashion, did you think of the fact? Because I have a friend who told me that you wake up in the morning and you're like, "Zenienda quality," you know. Then you're like, "It's what I'm going to do. It's my passion. It's what I want to do." Then you get there, and you find out it is not as earning as you want it to earn. Did you face any of those challenges where you had so much hope that probably in a month I could rake in 2 mil and then the month ends and you only have 100k?
Yeah, especially for 2019, that was the case. Because sometimes you plan for this month, maybe I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that. But also it comes to the clients.
Mm.
You know, are the clients coming in? are they the bargaining type? Are you going to tell them an amount and they just, you know, pay?
Mm.
So it all comes to that. You have to be persistent, you have to be patient. And you have to have it within your heart that whatever comes,
mm.
I will grow with it.
Yes, I'll grow with it. And, you know, nothing will stop me.
What do you think, you know, is failing us as the young people as far as, you know, following
straight
our dreams and, you know, having these hands-on skills that is concerned? Because you're having a couple of them coming out of campus and then they're saying there's unemployment. They're holding posts of what next. They also don't know what is going on. Why do you think that is the trend we are into? Why have we as young men failed to better ourselves in terms of different skills?
I think it's in the education system.
Mm-hmm.
Really?
Yes.
Don't Why would you say that?
Because the education system is training us to, okay, basing on my experience,
mm-hmm.
it's training us to learn what we have to learn in school and then go look out for jobs. And if like you have to get a job
mm-hmm.
out of school. But me, my the advice I would give to people is make life what you want it to be. If you go out of school and you're not getting a job, do something for yourself.
Mm.
You don't have to follow what everyone else is doing.
Mm.
You don't
sit
have
at home,
to
wait for a job.
Yes. I know someone who graduated. Okay, they spent 5 years at home.
Wow.
Yes, looking for a job. And I'm wondering why.
5 years, that's a lot of time.
Yes, that's a lot of time.
I know someone who went 9.
Okay,
and that
proceed.
And that keeps happening. And that keeps happening. And you wonder why.
Mm.
Why does it keep happening?
Mm-hmm.
Don't you have other things to do? Don't you have something that's a plan B, a plan C? Why do you keep looking for a job that may never come? Do something for yourself. Find your passion.
Wait,
do what you love.
In short terms.
Is there anything like someone not being able to have, you know, a particular skill that they're good at or maybe failing to find themselves? Someone may be out there and they're saying, okay, fine, I really want to find myself, but I'm failing to do that. How would you help that kind of person? Because I believe for you, you managed to find yourself a long period ago as far as, you know, fashion is concerned. Now, for someone there who's battling with how to find themselves, how would you help them out?
I don't think there's anyone who doesn't have what to do.
Mm.
Everyone has a talent.
Mm.
It can be as simple as cooking.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay.
It can be as simple as digital marketing.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
You're good with social media.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. Walk to Urban TV,
mm.
tell them I'm good with social media. Even when you studied law,
mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
you're good with social media.
Mm.
Walk to Urban TV, they'll give you a job.
Mm.
I don't think anyone can fail to get what to do.
Tina, can I ask you something?
Mm.
Apart from gossiping, what other thing are you good at?
She's good. That's her talent.
It didn't hurt my feelings because I have none. Any, apart from gossiping.
Yeah, apart from gossiping. What given your school and school background, that's why I say gossiping.
What am I good at? I'm good at a ton, track of so many things. First of all, I'm very handsy.
Uh-huh.
I can do anything pretty much with my hands. Mm. I can make jewelry. Mm. I love to farm. I love to dig. Oh. Come on, you know I'll be good. You know, I'll be good. And then I love to cook. It's something that I actually always wanted to go and do, like on a much more professional level. And I think I will do it.
Mm-hmm.
Finally made up my mind. Like she says, there is not a single person out there who doesn't have something they can excel at. It's all about you understanding there's a reason why I love this thing.
Okay.
So let me give it, you know, a bit of my time, nurture it, see how it comes out. When I started out with dog breeding, I just loved dogs.
Okay.
You know, I just wanted a cute dog. And then I fell in love with the process. I fell in love with understanding them. And then it became a passion.
Mm-hmm.
So there's always something each and every one of us can do.
You know, someone say, if you sleep, every day you wake up, you think about gossiping.
Mm-hmm.
Or every day you wake up, you think about sweeping. Mm-hmm. Every day you wake up, you think about singing. Mm. And you're either a gossiper, you're
a musician, or a cleaner, janitor.
Whatever you wake up thinking about every day, never gets off your mind.
That means I'm going to be Bill Gates. I'm going to be Bill Gates. I've been waking up thinking I'm
Bill Gates. You have been thinking about Bill Gates.
No. I've been thinking I'm Bill Gates. Every morning I wake up, Bill Gates.
Warren
Buffet, Warren Buffet.
When you laugh at someone going through something, you become like them.
Trust me, I am.
I have been laughing at Bill Gates, but. I don't know what is happening. Anyway, where do you see yourself in the next 5 years from now, as far as, you know, fashion design is concerned?
Oh, I see myself being a household name in Uganda, Africa. Mm-hmm. I see myself a rich woman.
Mochilava.
Yes. Yeah.
This color so much zeal, just too much motivation and drive. I know.
I
love it.
I want us to go back to the education that you talked about, where, you know, it lets us down as far as, you know, people finding their dreams is concerned and bettering their skills. That's some, of course, her work that she has done. If you're watching the show and you're wondering, why are we showing those pictures? Those are some of the dresses that, you know, Janet has been able to design. Coming back to the education, you know, system, the curriculum has been changed. I don't know if you've been following it up, and a couple of things have been adjusted here as far as, you know, studying is concerned. Now, you're looking at about from 8 a.m. up to 1:50 p.m., and then the rest of the day is, you know, getting into curricular activities, design, whatnot. Do you think with this kind of, you know, education system, we can maybe have a chance of having better people come out as far as, you know, having their dream is concerned and skilling themselves?
Obviously. Because it's, I think this new curriculum is good for someone who is, I'd say, out there. You know, is not so concealed, wants to come out. You know, someone who
thinks
so
out
much,
of the box.
Yes, who has so much energy, who has so much zeal, who has so much enthusiasm. Someone who really thinks out of the box, like she said. Yeah. I think it's good.
When do you think is the right time for someone to chase their dream? Is it after the university or even during the university period?
Before you even go to university.
All your life.
And actually, from the moment your parents introduce you to school, like, this is it. Yeah. You're like...
But then we have different dreams at that point in time.
Okay, well, let them keep growing and altering. Yeah. That's the thing about dreams. Dreams don't die. They either grow bigger or they alter. You have to nourish them. So if you woke up in the morning thinking you wanted to just be Bill Gates, get five other guys and then work five times harder than Bill Gates, that's the person you will be.
Yeah.
You have to set a target.
Okay. Janet, I want us to come back to, you know, the conversation that we're having. Transitioning from school to work, what has been your biggest challenge? As you know, you got to leave school and now you're getting to leave the dream that you've always wanted to leave.
I think in school, I wouldn't like to say everything is given to you, but most times it is.
Mm-hmm.
Everything is almost, your parents are still taking care of you. In school, maybe you're getting meals at school, like for me at UCU. Life is kind of like easy, but when you're out of school, life hits you.
Oh.
Yes, sometimes you have to parent for yourself. Sometimes you have to, you know, look for a job while feeding yourself, and it's not easy. Yeah. So the difference between that is there you're being fended for,
okay,
and out of school you're on your own. Yes.
You're in a very competitive industry. When we talk fashion, you have very many people who have already made a name as far as fashion is concerned in the country, and those people don't seem to be leaving the seat anytime soon. You know, you're coming in with a couple of whole lots of ideas, I believe. What makes you so different? What is going to make you outstanding that in 5 years you'll be able to achieve what you have set out to achieve?
I would say hard work, persistence. I'm looking at material manipulation, having something that you yourself does, not what everyone else does.
True.
Something
true.
That makes you stand out.
Unique.
I'm not going to spill right now. Yeah, but I'm also looking at collaborations with those different people that I look up to, Fatuma Asha, Beryl.
Yeah.
Yes, all those people. I'm looking at collaborations, and I hope they can, you know, put hands together with us, the young ones, and help us come up here.
Who do you think is the biggest fashion designer in Uganda now, according to you? Why you feel like they are still playing around?
You just put her in a spot.
I think most of them are good, and I don't think anyone has reached where they want to be.
Their peak.
Yes, most of them are still growing, and I commend them for that. And they have not put themselves out there as, I've made it. Or
some have.
I don't think so.
Come for the Aspas, you'll find out.
Yeah, but I think
you had to go there, didn't you?
Can't help myself.
Yeah, most of them are good, and I look up to them, and the people will inspire me to wake up every day and do something that I love.
Whose work inspires you the most in UG?
I think Fatuma Asha.
Oh, really? I would have figured you for a, you know, Beryl.
And yeah, Beryl for that, for her bridal stuff and all that. But Fatuma Asha is diverse. You know, she does this.
She's everywhere.
Yes.
Okay. Adds up.
Where do you get your designs from? I've been seeing a couple of pictures right there on the screen, and in my head I'm wondering, how do you come up with these particular designs in terms of, you know, how the dress is going to look like?
My head? Your head
then
is the
you
biggest.
Your
head
so
is
do
the
you
biggest
like sketch as well?
Yeah, I'm learning. I do, but I've not yet perfected it. Yeah, but I do sketch. Yeah, and also, you know, ideas you get from your mind, you merge them with like Pinterest, so you get
there's always
different,
something to play with.
Yeah.
Oh, Pinterest. I think I've seen you watch a couple of videos from
I am a Pinterest freak.
You get ideas from
that.
Everywhere.
Because I am Pinterest is bae. Pinterest can literally teach you how to build a house, build a car. I bet you can even learn how to build an atomic bomb on Pinterest. You just have to type it. Pinterest is bae. Trust me.
What has been, you know, one of the toughest times you've had to endure during, you know, the fact that you have to make your dream alive?
There's a time I didn't have money. Like, I wasn't getting business. And that happens all the time, I guess.
Dry spins.
Yeah, that was May 2019.
So how did you come out of it? You know, to the extent that you're still here, you're still focusing on your hard work, and you still want to live your dream.
I guess, I say I have a supportive boyfriend.
Ooh.
Yeah.
God damn!
That is when you know this relationship was defined.
Yo!
Ooh, child. Oh.
So you guys...
Keep going. You were saying about the boyfriend.
Yeah,
the boyfriend.
So even when I didn't have money...
He was there. Yeah.
Yes, he was there. I never lacked. I never... Yeah, so...
What
is
has been done for you as far as, you know, building
Oba
your
can you explain?
Time. Oba, you can explain. So is there watching?
Yeah, he is.
Oh, you told him there.
Bene, babe, thank you for looking after us.
However, let you a fashion designer.
Why are we teasing right now? We are stupid.
It's a good thing. Not every day you find someone who's going to tell you, you know what?
Because you know how Kampala girls, we just, they generalize, like, so do you have a man? Yeah.
So how long have you guys been, like, together?
More than a year.
Oh, it's still that young puppy love.
No, it's not actually.
Do tell.
Yeah, no more.
All right, last but not least, how do people get in touch with you on social media, probably?
Social media, Janet Pambara, everywhere. Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. I have a YouTube channel as well. My number. Can I get my number?
Oh, yeah, please.
0787-2450-30.
I like how it's very easy for someone to read out their number on air. You know?
I wish I could.
Don't
you wish
know?
You could actually read your number out? So
and then
my
no,
number.
Is, and then no one is going to mine. No one
actually, that's
a
business number.
Anything.
That's not my private number.
Amen.
Yeah.
For us, even business.
Either way,
number,
even business
throw.
Number.
Even
throw.
An email, mama.
You just give them social media and then DM becomes
I,
a DM.
I know. I said I gave someone my email address and it made me hate my email address.
Yeah.
Like I thought people would just get busy on social and DMs and calls.
Mm.
So I thought, email, who's going to want to send it? Mama. But why not?
What is your last advice to, you know, the young people out there, people who are going through school and, you know, they're looking forward to the day they get to, you know, graduate and boom, get into the real life?
Don't give up.
Mm.
Life is yours. Do whatever you want with it. If you want to fail, fail. If you want to succeed, succeed.
Amen. Just like my mother would have said it.
Also, what is your advice to people who are in relationships where their boyfriend or girlfriend does not support their dream?
Leave it.
Janet, mama, you tell us.
Leave it. Leave it.
What are you doing?
Janet Mpambara, ladies and gentlemen, get in touch with her on social media. Be able to support her also in case you've always had a dream of being a fashion designer and you've always wanted to work with someone who is new in the field, someone who at least has made a name for themselves as far as the fashion is concerned. She could be the person that you will definitely need on that one. A couple of pictures have been displayed on the TV for you to be able to know at least get a feel of what she does. Get over to her YouTube channel, Janet Mpambara, as well as social media, and get to catch up with more pictures of her different designs. Thank you very much, Janet, for coming through to the studio, and we wish you nothing but the best as far as your dream is concerned.
And hopefully you can make me pants that fit in that type that you're wearing.
Okay. Did you make those ones as well?
Yeah,
I need me something like that that fits.
And I need like shorts. I'm going to be having a holiday very soon, so.
Oh, we should do twinsies for the show.
I need shorts. Can you
we should do twinsies for the show. Get Willis one too, but I don't know if she can make baby clothes.
See, that's the problem.
Do you make baby clothes?
Do you make baby clothes?
I can.
You can.
Yeah, Willis is our baby on the show. So
yeah, but she's very short. You
can dress you maybe like for a week, sir.
Oh.
Like.
Let's talk business after the break. We'll catch you for the next hour. Well, but we'll be having, of course, the letters of what is happening within the relationships. We are talking about cheating.